What's happening everyone, my name is Alex and welcome back. For this camera comparison, we have the new Insta360 One RS, the 4K Boost Edition, and then we have the GoPro 10. Out of the two cameras, the GoPro 10 is a bit more expensive. Alright, so we're gonna split this video into three sections. The first section has to do with the internal microphones inside this camera, so we're gonna see some sample recording so we can figure out which camera has the better internal microphone. The second section has to do with the aim stabilization available on both cameras, so we're gonna see some footage walking, running and biking so we can figure out which camera has better aim stabilization. And the last section has to do with the video quality. And of course we're gonna see some daytime and nighttime sample video recordings at different resolutions. And with that being said, don't forget to press that like button and let's begin by checking out some sample recording so we can figure out which camera has the better internal microphone. Alright, we have a quick microphone test outdoors between the Insta360 One RS and of course the GoPro 10. I'm also outside as you can see for yourself, so it is a bit windy, so you may hear some wind aside from my voice. For this particular recording, I'm doing 4K 30 frames per second with both cameras, and I also have the highest level of aim stabilization enabled on both cameras. So yeah, this is how recording would sound from these two cameras if you're recording outdoors and you also have a bit of wind. For our second microphone test between the Insta360 One RS and of course the GoPro 10, I am indoors. In here there is no other noise aside from my voice. We don't have any wind or any other noise, so the only thing you should hear is my voice. So this is how the internal microphones on these two action cameras would capture sound indoors in a pretty quiet place. We are also recording in 4K at 30 frames per second. Okay, we are moving on to our next recording, and for this recording we are doing 4K at 30 frames per second on both cameras, and I have them both set to the maximum level of aim stabilization. Alright, so after checking out that footage, it seems to me that the GoPro 10 captures sound better than the Insta360 One RS. First of all, the sound is a bit louder and also a bit deeper, not to mention that if you have any wind whenever you're recording something, that wind really comes through the recordings done by the Insta360 One RS. So for me personally, I do prefer all the recordings done by the GoPro 10 for that particular test that we've done. Next, we're gonna move on and check out some sample recording so we can figure out which camera has better aim stabilization. Of course, that is available for both cameras at all resolutions. So let's check out those sample recordings, walking, running, biking, so we can figure out which camera does better. Alright, we have our first stabilization test between the GoPro 10 and of course the Insta360 One RS. For this recording, I'm walking slowly. As you can see, I'm also trying to keep the cameras as steady as possible. And we're recording in 4K at 30 frames per second with the maximum level of aim stabilization on both cameras. Next, I'm gonna show you how the aim stabilization works while running. Of course, I am recording in 4K at 30 frames per second with both cameras, and I have the aim stabilization level set to maximum on both cameras. So let's go running. Okay, next on the list we have a bit of a recording done while riding the bicycle, just so you can see how that stabilization works while riding a bicycle. Of course, we are using the GoPro 10 and the Insta360 One RS. I am also recording in 4K at 30 frames per second, and I have the level of aim stabilization set to maximum on both cameras. So let's go as fast as I can. We'll go this way. Turn left somewhere around here. It's also quite windy, so you're probably gonna hear some wind aside from my voice. So yeah, this is how recording would look like if you are riding a bicycle. And I also wanted to show you how the stabilization would work if you are recording in 4K at 60 frames per second. So you're gonna do a bit of walking. I'm also gonna pan around for a bit slowly, and we'll start running after that, just so you can see how that works at 4K at 60 frames per second. Alright, so after checking that footage, if you are walking nice and slow, I haven't actually noticed a difference between the two cameras. So they both do pretty good whenever you're walking, whenever you're panning slowly. But the biggest difference I've noticed whenever you're doing more sudden movements, more crazier movements, I'm gonna say. So for example, if you're running, the GoPro 10 does seem to do much better for that stabilization. The same kind of goes if you're riding a bicycle and you turn left, right, multiple times, and those movements are a bit more insane, let's call them that. So for stabilization, I feel that the GoPro 10 once again does a bit better than the Insta360 One RS, even though this is probably the second best action camera for stabilization that I got to try up until now. So next we are gonna check some more sample recordings at different resolutions. We are gonna start with the daytime recordings just so you can see which camera gets the better video quality. So let's check out those recordings and I will be right back. Okay, 30 frames per second. Next, we're gonna move on to a quick recording done in 1080p at 60 frames per second. I know that a lot of people do like recording at this resolution. I also have the instabilization set to the maximum level possible on both cameras, so on the GoPro 10 and of course the Insta360 One RS. We're gonna walk this way for a bit. Super cool place around here. So yeah, 1080p at 60 frames per second. And we are moving on to a quick recording done in 4K at 60 frames per second. Once again, for this recording, I'm using the maximum level of image stabilization on both cameras. And I'm walking fairly slow, trying to keep the cameras as steady as possible. I think I'm gonna stop somewhere around here. We're gonna pan right slowly. And back left. So yeah. 4K at 60 frames per second between the GoPro 10 and the Insta360 One RS. Okay, and we are moving on to a quick recording done in 1080p at 30 frames per second. I know that a lot of people do use this resolution quite a bit. Once again, I am using the GoPro 10 and the Insta360 One RS. So I'm gonna stop somewhere around here. We're gonna pan left. So I guess we'll stop here. We'll pan left slowly. And up and back right, so towards the sea. So yeah, this whole recording done in 1080p at 30 frames per second would look like between these two action cameras. And we are moving on to another quick recording done in 4K at 30 frames per second. Here where I am right now, it's not that windy anymore, so most likely you're only gonna hear my voice, you're not gonna hear any wind. I have the image stabilization set to the maximum level available on both cameras. We're gonna pan left slowly, so towards these houses. And back right. And we'll actually turn around. It is super hot out. We have about 40 degrees, that's Celsius. So yeah. 4K at 30 frames per second between these two action cameras, so the GoPro 10 and the Insta360 One RS. Alright, so after checking out the daytime footage that you've just seen, it seems to me that most recordings done by the Insta360 One RS are a bit sharper, so the video quality is a bit better from the Insta360 One RS in my opinion. Now, for dynamic range in those recordings, it does seem that the GoPro 10 does a bit better. As for colors, well, I used both cameras in the vivid color profile, so you could change that on both cameras if you don't want those more saturated colors, I'm gonna say. So for video quality during the day, it almost seems to me that the Insta360 One RS is a bit better than the GoPro 10. But again, leave a comment down below and let me know your thoughts. Do you prefer this one or this one for video recordings? And again, that kind of changes depending on the resolution that you are using. But I did show you a few resolutions just so you can see for yourself. Next, we're gonna move on and check out some nighttime recordings. Again, I have three nighttime recordings at different resolutions, just so you can see how each camera does. So let's check those out. All right, and we're moving on to a quick recording in low light between the Insta360 One RS and of course the GoPro 10. For this recording, I'm doing 4K at 30 frames per second with both cameras. I'm also gonna show you a recording with 4K at 60 frames per second, but that's gonna be the next one. So I'm walking slowly and I'm trying to keep the cameras as steady as possible. I guess we'll turn right, so we'll walk towards my scooter. Again, we have some street lights around here, but I feel that most people would record in these kind of conditions, so in a place where there are some street lights as well. So yeah, 4K 30 frames per second between the GoPro 10 and the Insta360 One RS in low light. Okay, next on our list between the Insta360 One RS and of course the GoPro 10, I am recording in 4K at 60 frames per second. Again, around here it is a bit darker. I just wanted to show you how the footage would be if you're filming somewhere where there isn't as much light. Walk towards the light a bit. I can see a bit more on the screen of the GoPro 10, but again, we'll have to see how this footage looks on the computer. So 4K at 60 frames per second in low light. And I might as well show you a quick recording done in 1080p at 30 frames per second, once again, between the GoPro 10 and the Insta360 One RS. So once again, the image looks a bit brighter on the screen of the GoPro. But we still have to see how this footage actually looks on the computer. So we'll walk this way, it gets a bit darker around here. So yeah, 1080p at 30 frames per second in low light between the Insta360 One RS and of course the GoPro 10. Alright, so after checking out the nighttime footage, it seems to me that the Insta360 One RS does better than the GoPro 10. At least whenever you're doing 30 frames per second, the video quality kind of decreases whenever you're doing 60 frames per second in low light. But compared with the GoPro 10, yes, the Insta360 One RS does seem to do much better. Realistically, no action camera does amazing in low light, but the Insta360 One RS does okay for those recordings that you've just seen, at least in my opinion. I also have a few pictures that I took over the past couple of days here, and I'm having those displayed on the screen right now, just so you can see how they look. I mean, for some pictures the GoPro does better, for some pictures the Insta360 does better, and realistically, if you do have a newer phone in your pocket, it is possible that your phone is gonna take better pictures than these cameras. So those are just some sample pictures that I took over the past couple of days. So there you have it, the Insta360 One RS, the 4K Boost Edition, and the GoPro 10. Which one do you guys prefer, this one or this one? Definitely leave a comment down below and let me know your thoughts. Alright guys, hopefully this video was useful. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one.